you are working for some library management system of three different campuses. Okay, let us assume it that way. Okay, and all one person is working for Bangalore library management system, the other is working for Ettimadai library management system, and the third one is for Ambattapuri management system. And each one of you are working on your own standalone system. Now, let us assume that the university gives a provision of some interlibrary loan. Okay, I hope you remember interlibrary loan. We had one of the case studies for writing your ER diagram, interlibrary loan. So interlibrary loan means if I do not have a book, let us say I'm trying to borrow a book from Bangalore campus. So if that book is not available, I will access, I will communicate this with the other two campuses and check if this book is available in the other two campuses, right? So in such situations is where I will be using a distributed database. So how is this different from the normal standalone system? In distributed database system, what we have is, besides having a standalone system means you have a server at one place, you have all the data at one place, and you're working with those data. In distributed systems, what happens is the servers are distributed at different places, and you will be communicating with these two different servers are communicating with each other through one communication module. Okay, I repeat, you have multiple servers geographically present at different places, and these two servers are communicating with each other. That's called one patch is added. When I say one patch is added, it means that one more module is added. And what is that module? That module is communication module. And why do we have this communication module? The communication module is for the very purpose, as the name suggests, for the purpose of communication. Who is communicating here? Between two servers. And why are they communicating? To access the data. Now, I gave you the example of, one second. I gave you the example of, I gave you the example of interlibrary loan. I gave you the example of interlibrary loan. So when I accessed my database, I realized that I did not see, I will execute one query. Let us assume that we have a distributed database system. It's already set up, okay? So I will have to write a query saying that select star from, Bangalore library where book equals database. I will write this query, and this query is not at all new to you, right? So I'll say select star from Bangalore library where book equals databases. So now if it is a standalone systems are those applications which you worked on in your fifth semester. If it is a standalone system, there's only one query, one way of execution that gets executed, and you get the data. If it is a distributed system, there are two ways in which this can be executed. One is a standalone way, and the other is to run this particular query that you wrote in the communication module. That is, you're running that particular query on the network. Okay, so which means that whatever query that you write, that gets embedded in your communication module. So when I type the query, in case the standalone system, it will execute the query. If the data is not present there, that query will get activated in your communication module. So when it gets embedded in a communication module, it means that I'm running that particular query over the network. So when I say select star from library where book equals databases, wherever this particular row filtering is present, I mean book equals database is true, whether it is in Ettimadai campus or in Kochi campus or whatever the campus is, everything I will be able to retrieve, and I'll get the result at the place where who initiated that particular query. I initiated that query. Bangalore campus initiated that query. So Bangalore campus will get all the data together. This is what is a distributed data system, if I have to tell you in a nutshell. This is how your project should also look like. So when you do your project, your distributed, what is expected of you is either do a distributed database application, or you could do an object, a standalone object oriented database project. Anyway, object oriented, I will tell you as and when we proceed, but right now we are concentrating only on the distributed data system, database system. So with respect to in today's session, what I'm going to tell you is regarding what is associated with your project and your lab sessions. Okay, otherwise theory part, we'll do it in the theory part itself. So what is expected of you is, as I said, you would be doing one distributed database application. You can choose either distributed database application, or you can choose an object-oriented application or a documented-oriented databases. And as I said, I repeat, we'll be starting off with the distributed database system. So as I said, you will be working in a team. Now, team size, is three fine with you all students? Are you all fine with three members? Are you all there, first of all? Are you listening?
Yes, ma'am.
So yes, three ma'am. Members, three members are fine with everybody?
Ma'am, if possible, can we try for four at least?
Okay, why? Actually, four is a crowd. For a, see, and this is a project, I mean, DBMS project is something that you've already done. And in fact, I remember Rajesh sir telling, he was the one who reviewed all the projects. He's there with us in this lab also. And I remember him telling me that this batch had done a really very good project. I just happened to see just few of them. We'll do one thing. We'll keep it as three. And in case I don't want everybody to come with a request, somewhere, okay, slight flexible is possible, but I prefer three. Okay, let us keep it to three. If it is inevitable and you don't want to leave your friend and all those, you know, emotion things and all runs up here, we'll see that. Okay, but ideally three would be better, I feel. We'll see that. Okay, so as of now, team size is three. Chandana has something to say?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So three is the team size, and the evaluations will be in two reviews would be there for the project. Now, I'm just telling you a gist of everything in today's session, okay? So what you'll have is two reviews. In the first review, you will be telling what tools you're going to use or what kind of project you're going to do. You will be able to decide that in probably 1 or 10 days time, or maybe 2 weeks time. Okay, in 2 weeks time, you will be able to decide on what tool you're going to use to do your project. That would be your first review along with your mid-sem. Okay, let me tell you regarding the evaluation also. There is a slight change in the evaluation pattern. I am sure you would be knowing by now. You do not have the T1 and T2 concept. You just have your mid-sem component now. So the evaluation pattern, I haven't made a slide as such, but I'll just tell you orally. But however, I will be sharing a document per se. But as of now, let me tell you, you'll have one quiz, one midterm exam, and project two reviews, and one end semester. A quiz, one mid-sem, two project evaluations, and one end semester. This is what has been decided. Okay, this. So we have, these are the four components we'll be having, and the project evaluations, you'll have two evaluations. The first one, as I said, is a tool, and the second one is the overall. Finally, you'll have to design your application and give the final demo and implementation, and you'll also have to generate a report. So that would be your second submission. And with respect to the weightage, quiz will be for 10 marks, just one quiz, 10 marks. Midterm exam will be for 20 marks, 10 plus 10. 10 plus 10 means 10 marks theory and 10 marks viva. I mean, 10 marks written and 10 marks viva. So 10 plus 10, this is 20. Lab evaluation, project evaluation would be 15 plus 25. 15 for the first review, 25 for the second review. So that counts to 40 marks. So quiz 10 marks, mid-sem 20. When I say lab evaluations, it's project students. So project would be 40. So 10 plus 20 plus 40 is 70. So it's 70-30 component, 30 marks for your end semester, where 10 marks is for written and 20 marks for the viva. That is how it has been designed this time. And yeah, that's regarding your submission part and all. Yeah, there are. So that's regarding your project part. And to start off with the lab component in today's session, as I said, though your syllabus says distributed database is the third unit to cover, we'll be starting off with it for the reason that distributed database is an extension of your RDBMS, and more or less the queries are the same. So the project is also, you'll be able to start off with your project also easily. So prior to we getting into the ADBMS concept specifically, see, when I say a distributed databases, it would be pretty obvious by now, you would have understood by now that it is retrieving from multiple tables. So in today's session, what is expected of you is to go back to your fifth semester, you know, lab sessions. Just today's lab session for, you know, for the 1 hour, whatever time we have till 2:45, we will be executing few queries where you would be retrieving data from multiple tables. So which software did you use in fifth semester for this? It's necessary. The queries are the same as what you did for your SQL. So you have to remember them. One of you tell me. Which software did you use? Nobody is answering.
Oracle MySQL.
Oracle Live SQL, right? Fine, who said that?
Priya, ma'am.
Priya, okay, Priya. Yeah. So Oracle Live SQL. So what is expected of you right now is all of you please move on to Oracle Live SQL. I'll give you a few tables and I want you all to execute few queries that requires fetching data from multiple tables. Do you remember the query, students? Do you remember writing the queries?
Yes, ma'am.
Only Priya remembers, the others don't remember? Sri Harshini, Priyadarshan, Shruti. I can see only these names here in the front. Don't you all remember? How? Yeah.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
Yes. So you can please log into your Oracle Live SQL now. All of you, please log into Oracle Live SQL. I'll ask you to share the screen. I'll just type two tables in the comment. You can have a look. You can write this. Create these tables with appropriate primary key and foreign key. In student, registration number is the primary key. In course table, C number is the primary key. In course registration, you have C number and registration number together as a primary key. I hope you remember how to write the queries. Create table name, open the bracket. Attribute name, data type size, comma, attribute 2, data type size, so on. And in case it is a primary key, you give it as attribute name, space, data type size, then give a space and write primary key. Primary and key are two different words. Somebody is leaving the class. I want everybody to please create those three tables that I have given. I'll ask you to share the screen. You need help in creating the table, students. I hope you all are doing the work. Somalingeshwar Reddy, please share your screen.
Ma'am, I'm doing it, ma'am. I will share 5 minutes later. No?
Students, if you do not remember the syntax, you have to tell me. Vikas, I may require a help from you. Can you collect the team and give me the team's names? Vikas is here in this class. What you can do is, students, I'll ask Vikas to collect the names, teams from you. So you can pass your names and your registration number and your name to Vikas. Probably he'll forward, I mean, he'll circulate a Google form or other kind so that you can fill it and send it to him. You don't have to think about a topic right now because we've just started. The team you decide. Preferably three, in case it is inevitable, you give four, let us see. Kasima, can you share your screen, ma?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. I'm glad you remember the queries. Good.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Kasim.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
What about Dharma Teja? Dharma Teja. Yes. Dharma Teja, can you please share your screen? Missing right ramps. Can you zoom it a little more? Yeah, I first saw some of this. Okay, you can stop sharing. I mean, a lot of disturbance there. I'm just typing few queries that you can try executing on your tables that you have created. I have posted six questions, sorry, five questions. I want you all to execute them. Students, I just wanted to know, is this how the strength is in the other courses also for your regular courses besides your elective?
Yes, ma'am.
Why is it like this? You don't have your placements now, no? If you have placements, it's fine. Why is it, even if it is in the morning session also, it's like this? I'm just curious because the strength is really very bad. It's very alarming to see that. Oh my God, see, from 36 it went to 50, now back to 39. So almost 40, 45 students are not there. Students, you're all able to do the queries? There is absolutely silence, I mean absolute silence from your side.
Inserting values.
Oh, you're inserting values. Is that what you said, Priya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, okay. Somalingeshwar, I asked you to share the screen then, and you said you would and you did not. Please share the screen now. Show me how much you've done.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Can you see my screen, ma'am?
Ah, yes. Can you zoom it a little more, ma'am? Okay.
Created the tables and I'm writing the queries which you are given.
Okay. Good.
Okay.
You're able to, yeah, you can stop sharing. You're able to recall the query, students? I'm just curious. Or yeah, is it that you're referring to something else? Students, please talk.
We are able to do it, ma'am.
Okay. Students, you may try this now. We'll wind up for today. Tomorrow I have your theory class in the second hour. We'll continue then. And for your next lab session, we'll start off with the execution of queries in the distributed databases. Okay. We'll do it now, then. So for today, this is what was planned, just to for you to recollect the previous queries. And it's nice that you remember at least few of you. At least say an okay for this now.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
See, now everybody okay. Now when you have to leave the class. Yeah. Okay, then we'll meet tomorrow in the second hour. Okay, bye. Thank you.
Thank you,
ma'am.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Can we have four members in a project team? Like,
yes, ma'am.
That's exactly this what I said just now. I mean, not just now, I told in between that three is what is ideal. But then if you really can't leave your fourth friend, it is OK. You can give the name. We'll see. OK, we'll consider. You give the names. We'll see.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
OK,
thank you.
Yeah. OK, thank you. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Ma'am.
Bye. Bye.